the habitat of the gorilla.
Hello, I'm Rob Coster, and I'm currently tracking down the eastern lowland gorilla.
He usually roams around forestry-type areas, lowland areas, though, and usually eats bamboo and stuff like that. I'm going to try and hunt him down because there's plenty of bamboo around this area, so I'm expecting to see an eastern lowland gorilla. So just follow me, and we'll hopefully find one. Hey, you see all the bamboo I'm pushing out of the way. Sometimes gorillas actually drink bush beer. They sometimes prefer this. They steal from the natives that live around this area. We just push all this brush out of the way, and hopefully we'll come across a gorilla somewhere over here. Now, gorillas, maybe we'll come across a gorilla nest somewhere in our voyage. Gorillas usually build a nest about 2 to 3 feet wide, and they gather all sticks and bamboo and place it around in a circular pattern. Anyway, oh my God. Just watch out. Right over there, ladies and gentlemen, right there, behind those bushes, is an eastern lowland gorilla. Now, I don't know if you can see him. I'm gonna try and get close as I can to this gorilla. Now, the key is with gorillas, you have to be very, very quiet. So I'm gonna take it down a notch right now, because the gorilla might run away. So just follow me quietly. Right behind those trees, class, Mr. King, is a eastern lowland gorilla. Now, it's a very good thing that we came across him for my presentation here. Now, we're gonna try and get really close to this. So I don't know how close I can get, but we're gonna try. Gorillas aren't very fierce animals, but if, like, they feel troubled or frightened, they will attack. He looks to feel threatened by my presence. Now, I don't know if you have a close-up shot, but try and get his eyes in there. They probably look ferocious right now with my presence so close. I don't know where his... I don't know where his family is. Okay, just be quiet. Don't make any sound. He's very threatened by me right now. Now, right now, he's very threatened by our presence. His presence. He's very threatened by the presence of us. And I don't know if he's going to attack us, but if we attack, we have our Jeep over there that we can just hop into, and we can safely get away. This gorilla over here, he's still threatened by us. He calmed down a little bit. Now, I heard natives walking somewhere over there, so hopefully they can, like, veer the gorilla off out of our direction, because we don't want to make any sudden moves, so this gorilla, we don't want him to attack us. And, ladies and gentlemen, look how close this gorilla is. I think he's attacking the villagers instead of us. Now, if you can get a close-up on the villagers, come this way. Oh my God, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to witness an eastern lowland gorilla. Oh my God, listen to this. Look at this attack, dude. Look at this attack. Now let's go. Let's get out of here. Attack on. Keep it. You got it on? Keep this on. Oh my God, he's coming. Get him. straight for us, ladies and gentlemen. Straight for us. The gorilla is after us. Oh my God. Everyone get in his jeep. Get a God. He's coming straight for us. Threatened for, and he's protecting his family.
He's on the roof,
ladies and gentlemen. Let me get an outside view. There he is! Oh my God!
Oh my God, did someone fart?
Gorilla. The earliest gorillas lived in trees, yet today they spend only about 20% of their waking hours in trees. Gorillas never swing through trees. Instead, they climb slowly and steadily, testing each branch before putting their weight on it. Scientists believe that all gorillas once belonged to a single population. Get that. Over a long time, changes in climate and habitat separated them into three groups. The eastern lowland gorilla, the western lowland gorilla, and the mountain gorilla. Slightly different habitats, though, cause changes in size, color, and arm length. Yeah.
Gorillas never hunt for small animals, and they seldom eat insects except for a few fruits. These creatures only eat plants. Their diet includes ferns, herbs, vines, shrubs, stems, roots, and tree bark. One scientist counted 100 different plants eaten by eastern lowland gorillas. Gorillas usually get their water supply from the plants they eat, but have been documented to scoop up poop with their hands.
The gorilla's habitat is in danger though from the mining of a certain mineral. Cell phones, laptops, and video